Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new, welcome. My name is Faith. Thank you so much for being here. If you are new here, I am currently pregnant with baby number two. I have one daughter, her name is Summer. She's 2 years old, and I am now 17 weeks pregnant with baby number two. I'm due in early 2022, and I'm super, super excited. I've done quite a few videos so far on my pregnancy. I will link them all below in my description box in case you want to kind of catch up. But really, my pregnancy so far has felt fairly similar to how it felt with Summer, but I've been doing things, like quite a few things, very differently this time around. So I figured it would be fun to share with you guys what I'm doing differently. Some of them are pretty like simple, fun little things, and other things are definitely more serious and took more thought to consider doing things differently. So make sure you stay all the way through to the end to hear all 10. I think I've compiled 10 things I'm doing differently this pregnancy. And if you are new here and like what you see as you watch, I would also love it if you would consider subscribing to my channel before you leave. But that is it. Let's hop right on into the video. Okay, so I'm gonna start with the like easier ones, or like the least controversial ones, the ones where I feel like people won't come at me for them. And then we'll get into like the trickier ones. Number one, I feel like I've definitely been eating healthier this pregnancy. I have all my notes here on my phone, so that's why I just pulled this out. I need this even when I'm not pregnant, but with pregnancy brain, I need this to keep me on track. So yeah, number one, I've definitely been eating healthier earlier this time around. I think with Summer in my third trimester, I ate super, super healthy, but I really in the first trimester did terribly with it because I just felt so sick and only wanted to eat carbs and just stuff that would make me feel better. I definitely did do that as well this time around in the first trimester, but it wasn't nearly as bad. And now in my second trimester, I'm already really focusing on making healthy choices, eating lots of fruits and vegetables. I still will indulge every once in a while because when you're pregnant, it's kind of just an excuse to do it. But I've really been making sure this time around to get a lot of nutrients into my body. One thing I'm really focused on right now is getting enough protein because I've just noticed I'm not eating enough protein. Avocado is really, really good. I've been eating a lot of avocados and just a lot of fruit. Berries, grapes, watermelon, bananas, apples, just like so much fruit. Number two, and this might change as I get bigger, but I have not been using my pregnancy pillow this time around. I started using my pregnancy pillow when I was pregnant with Summer, like really early. I'd say at the end of my first trimester into my second, just because I was really sore already. I guess my body was going through it for the first time. I don't know. I mean, I'm sore now, but I just haven't felt the need to use my pregnancy pillow. I've just been using a pillow between my legs, and then I've really been loving this pillow from Sutera. This is an ergonomical memory foam pillow. I've been loving it. Nick tries to steal it from me constantly. I tend to sleep really like tight, like up like this, and especially when you're pregnant, that's the last thing you need. And these little nooks here are just perfect for your neck area, and it's really helped me be comfortable at night. I know you can get these on Amazon or their website, so I'll make sure to put links for it down below. I highly recommend it if you're not really into the massive pregnancy pillow. I probably will use it alongside this in my third trimester, we'll see. And Sutera did give me a discount code to share with you guys. It's Faith20, and that will get you a discount if you're interested in trying this out. Even if you're not pregnant, I recommend it. I think I'll continue to use it even when I'm not. It probably would be really, really comfortable for nursing as well. I could kind of put this behind my back, and the memory foam is just like so nice. It's really nice memory foam. The cover is washable, so that's good too. There's a zipper on the back, and you can just unzip this and machine wash it. It got some really good reviews on Amazon as well, so definitely check out the reviews if you've been trying to look for something like this. The claims are that it's a high density active bliss memory foam. It's adaptive to body weight and shape. It's cooling, breathable, and it has that removable cover that I mentioned. So thanks to Sotera for partnering with me on this portion of the video, but let's continue in to the things I'm doing differently this pregnancy. The third thing I'm doing differently is I am drinking caffeine. I had heard people who are pregnant still having like a cup of coffee a day, caffeinated coffee, and I just thought, wow, you're really like not supposed to do that. I don't know like why some people are doing that. But my doctor this time around, I have a different OB this time around, came right out and said I'm allowed to have 200 milligrams of caffeine a day. So I'm taking her up on that. I guess the like zero caffeine thing is more of a myth. When I was pregnant with Summer, I was told only decaf coffee. Decaffeinated coffee can have a lot of like chemicals in it because of the process that they put it through to make it decaf. So I had to really go out there and find like water filtered ones, I think it's called, like some of the organic ones are, but it was kind of difficult to be able to find that because I didn't want to be ingesting chemicals, but I really wanted a nice cup of coffee. So this time around, I'm just sticking with some caffeinated coffee, and sticking to 200 milligrams is not too bad for me. I really am only like a 1 to 2 cup coffee person anyways, and 200 milligrams is more than you think. So I looked it up, and for instance, in a Starbucks espresso, there is 75 milligrams of caffeine. So even in a venti, which is I think 3 shots of espresso, you're like right around that 200 mark. I probably should be getting a grande, which I think is just 2 shots of espresso. But yeah, it's pretty easy to figure out. I mean, it's a little bit more difficult when you make your coffee at home because you don't really know how much you're putting in there. At least I don't know. I kind of just like dump it in there, but it's not too difficult. And I really do enjoy having a little bit of caffeine. It's helped a lot with the drowsiness that comes from number 4, which is that I have been taking nausea medication, and I'm tapered off of it for the most part. I only have a little bit of nausea left over, but it's really not bad at all. But in the first trimester, just like with Summer, I got so nauseous, like 24/7 morning sickness. It was terrible. Not a ton of throwing up, but just like constantly feeling sick. And with Summer, my first pregnancy, I never really was given the option from my doctor of taking medication. It might've been my fault because I wasn't very vocal about it, but this time around I knew I was going to need to do something differently to combat it because I'm also taking care of a toddler now, and I just knew my body, I wasn't going to be able to handle it. So this time around I took Unisom and B6. They also have a prescription one called Diclegis and Bongesta, which is basically the same thing. I just got the over-the-counter stuff, and it significantly helped. I'd say it cut it in about half the nausea, but it does make you really, really drowsy. So that's why I mentioned it was nice to have some caffeine. I think we're on number 5. Number 5 is I have not been as worried and consumed about like not dyeing my hair or getting my nails done. I know when I was pregnant with Summer, I was really, really overly concerned about the chemicals and things like that. But what I realized is I do it so rarely that it really can't make that much of a difference. And it makes me feel like in a better mood when I'm put together. Also, the type of hair dye I use, I do my own highlights. I don't even touch it to my root. So I don't even think there would be an issue with that. But I know that that can be like a big thing with people. They get worried about coloring their hair while pregnant and things like that. When I was pregnant with Summer, I totally stopped coloring my hair. I maybe did it once because it was so grown out. But I was like really concerned about it and worried. I also was worried about getting my nails done and like using acetone to take off my nail polish and stuff. But this time around, I'm just not as concerned about it. I think that was maybe more of a fear of mine than an actual logical concern. However, if you know something I don't know, please feel free to share with us in the comments if there are safer alternatives or safer ways to do some of those cosmetic things. Okay, number 6. I have a completely different mindset when it comes to taking care of my rest. So when I was pregnant with Summer, I had a completely different lifestyle. I was going into an office 40 hours a week plus doing YouTube. So I was super, super busy regardless. But I remember back then I would feel really, really guilty if I wanted to just like rest all weekend or rest all night. I felt like I should be doing something. I should be getting things ready for the baby, or I should just be more productive. And this time around, I think because I know what's coming, like I know how hard the newborn stage is and how little sleep I'm gonna get, I'm giving myself like some breathing room, basically. Especially now that I'm taking care of a toddler, it's more physical work, I'd say, while being pregnant. If I wanna take a nap one day, I let myself take a nap and I don't feel guilty about it. Whereas if I would have taken a nap when I was pregnant with Summer, I would have felt guilty about it. I would have felt like I should have been doing something. This time around, I'm just resting when I can rest and not really stressing about anything. And I think, again, it's definitely because I know what to expect from this baby, this next baby, most likely. And I know how taxing it is. So I'm really just like soaking in the time I do have, where I have some like peaceful time to myself, because I know that that's going to change. Next thing I've been doing different is I am definitely more active. So this kind of ties into what I was just talking about. My lifestyle is very different now. I'm not sitting at a desk 40 hours a week. I am taking care of a house. I'm running after a toddler. Summer and I go on walks like multiple times a week, or we just like run around in the backyard. So I am much more active. And it's really interesting because along with eating healthier and being more active, I sort of thought I was going to gain less weight this pregnancy than I did with her, but I have already gained just as much, if not more, as I did at this point with Summer. So I don't know what's up with that. Maybe it's just because this is my second time around, so everything's like happening faster. I would say this isn't on my list, but something different this time around is I am a little more concerned, not concerned, just sort of like, about the weight gain. With Summer, I think because it was my first time, I was just so excited to be pregnant. I thought it was really fun that my body was getting bigger. But this time around, I'm kind of just like, you know, I hope that I can like lose weight once the baby's born, which I know is silly. Like you shouldn't think like that. But yeah, that's definitely been in the back of my mind, but I've been more active. So hopefully just in general, I will be more physically fit to give birth. Not that my giving birth experience last time was bad. My labor was really quick. It was more my recovery that was tough. So maybe this time around, my recovery will be hopefully easier. The next one, I've lost count. I don't know if it's 8 or 9, but I am not going to be doing a baby shower. I think this is probably pretty typical for second time moms or like pregnant moms, especially if they're close together. So like I said earlier, Summer is 2. I still have all of her baby stuff. There's really no need for me to do a big baby shower. Honestly, I would feel kind of like silly asking people to come and like give me stuff when I just asked them to do that a couple years ago. I still have all the stuff I'm really going to need. I did though still create a registry on Babylist. Babylist is the registry service I used last time around. It's really cool. I actually made a whole video on Babylist. I'll link that down below in case you are looking to put together a baby shower registry. It's really nice because you can link things from any different online store. So you can literally get anything from anywhere all put in one place. So I really like Babylist, and I figured I'd make myself kind of almost like a checklist or something that I can share with like really close family and friends. If they want to get me something, I can share them that registry link and they can see kind of what I'm looking to get. I might do like a tiny little sprinkle, I think they're called, but I'm really not thinking about it too much yet. We will see, but I'm definitely not doing a big baby shower. Next thing is, if you guys followed me when I did my vlogs after Summer was born, I did a lot of vlogging and talked a lot about her milk and soy protein intolerance. So it made breastfeeding very difficult. She was very cranky. I had to completely cut out dairy, anything milk product based, soy, which is in everything packaged almost. Like, it's really hard to find something without some sort of soy in it. Because there's all different names for soy too. So I had to really research that. I also ended up cutting out tomatoes, beef, eggs, corn. There were so many other things that just triggered her digestive system and made her upset. So I was on a super strict diet when I was breastfeeding her. And I am strongly considering starting that diet in my third trimester, simply because I know that there's a really good chance my next baby could also have this intolerance, and I just don't want to deal with how mad and upset a newborn can be when they have this intolerance. It's something that Summer completely grew out of. By a year old, she can have milk and cheese and everything like that and be totally fine. It typically is something that babies grow out of as they become toddlers, but it can really, really affect them when they're newborns. So I still have to ask my doctor, the gastro doctor, what he would suggest. I'm kind of guessing he's going to say not to start it early, because then you won't really ever know if the baby actually does have an issue. But I'm really considering it just because I really don't want to go through what we went through with Summer. It takes a good 3 to 4 weeks for all of those things to fully leave your system. So if I was to be ingesting that stuff, the baby would be consuming it for like 4 weeks, even if I stopped eating it. So that's kind of why I want to start it early and just get it all out of my system. And now also I learned a lot about what I can eat when I'm on that diet. So there's a lot more I can eat than I realized, and I'm not worried about being able to like feed myself nutritious things and stuff like that, because you can eat all vegetables and fruits, obviously. So I'm strongly considering doing that. If you follow me because you also went through that, let me know if with baby number two, you had the same issue, or if you started the diet early. I'd love to hear from you. The last one, which is probably the most controversial one, or it's just the one that is probably most uncomfortable for me to talk about, because it's not something I love that I'm doing differently, but it's just something that had to be done. I am staying on my antidepressant this pregnancy. I posted a video maybe 3 or 4 months ago, maybe longer than that, talking about my anxiety and depression. I had never talked about it before. I had hidden it, which we're very good at doing, people with anxiety and depression. But I went through it really bad after Summer was born, a lot to do with the issues she was having. It didn't help, but just being a first-time mom in general is so overwhelming. I guess I should backtrack a little bit. I had weaned off my antidepressant during my pregnancy with Summer because I was very consumed and worried about the risk factors that come with it. With the type of medication I'm on and the low dose I'm on, every doctor I've talked to has said it's most likely never going to be an issue for your baby. However, there is a slight risk. It's not like an approved drug to be taking during pregnancy, if you know what I mean. But I weaned off of it. I was doing okay, but because I was still off of it after giving birth and like breastfeeding and all of that, I just like crashed. It was bad. I had a whole downward spiral. I stopped YouTube. If you guys have been following me for a while, you know that I stopped YouTube for like 6-7 months. It was a really, really bad time. And I just don't want to put myself through that again. I think it's safe enough to where it's more important for me to have my mental health, especially now that I'm going to have 2 children to take care of, and an older child, 2 or 3, who will more understand my emotions and my feelings. It was one thing when it was a newborn and I was kind of like crying or like mentally upset. The newborn doesn't get it. I don't want to put Summer through that if I'm a mess once the baby is born. So I'm just going to stay on it through the pregnancy, keep myself even keel, and go from there. I've talked to many moms who have done this as well, And it's a very tough decision to make, especially if you're one who really doesn't like to be on medication when pregnant or breastfeeding. I get it. It's not something I'm super like proud of or love that I'm doing, but it's just, I had to make a choice between my mental health or no drug pregnancy. And I chose my mental health this time. And I think all in all, it's just going to be better for everybody in my life and the baby as well, because I'm going to be able to be a better mom. Okay. I think that is all of them. Yes, that is all 10 things I'm doing differently this pregnancy. I hope that you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Let me know if you're pregnant this time around as well. I know that a bunch of you have messaged me saying that we're pregnant at the same time again. So let me know if you're doing anything differently this time around. And also let me know your thoughts on any of the things I mentioned. I always love having conversations with you guys in the comments section. So feel free to leave me a comment. I always respond. Or you can DM me on Instagram. I always respond to those as well. But that is it, guys. I love you all so, so much. And I hope to see you in the next video. Bye.